This is a bit of a different video, but I wanted to share my top 10 songs of 2022. This is somewhat inspired by the Spotify Wrapped, but not exactly my results. I was on a shared Spotify at the beginning of the year, and I really only made my account, my own like premium account, in the fall. So my Wrapped results weren't like fully authentic of the year. So in this video, I'm also going to address some of my personal connections to the songs, like why I like them, and then interpretations of the lyrics, English major style, because I'm about to be an English teacher and starting my student teaching very soon. So this is going to be beyond just giving a top 10 tier list thing. And yeah, the list isn't in any particular order. None of these songs are really better than the others. They're just songs that I listened to a lot this year. And they're not songs that came out in 2022, just songs that I listened to. So this is kind of like for the future. So if I ever look back and want to know what my 2022 sounded like, this is what it is. Let me know what songs you guys listen to in the comments, and maybe next year I'll do a similar video. We can see what's changed. Here are some honorable mentions before we get into the list. As of year, this is probably my favorite song of all time. The theme of unrequited love is a powerful one, and Big Machine eloquently highlights the features of being in this type of dynamic of wanting someone and waiting for someone, but them never wanting you. The song describes this state as being blind, which it is. It's really blind and stupid and irrational to be devoted to nothing, but it's also very human, and in my opinion, it's a representation of love. It's kind of a sad realization, however, but the song is incredibly upbeat and catchy. The poetic lyrics of the Goo Goo Dolls shine through in this song, through moments such as "Love and Sex and Loneliness, Take What's Yours and Leave the Rest," which demonstrates that the speaker can have love without sex, or sex without love. They just want that one person, which is pretty deep. I also particularly love the poetry of "Swallow all your bitter pills, that's what makes you beautiful." It's just such an interesting idea that the more bitter someone is, and maybe even the more toxic they are, that the more beautiful that they can be. How blue is your heart is such a good rhetorical question as a lyric. I feel like everyone goes through shit in life, and when you meet someone you want to be romantic with, they're not a blank slate. They come with a background and life experiences that will have left them scarred and defeated and sad at some point in their life. Asking how blue their heart is doesn't just validate their experiences, but shows that you really want to get to know them and go as deep as possible to help heal them and make new love together. The song also acknowledges that the singer slash the listener has a blue heart and has a troubled life and loneliness as well. This song has some slow moments, but is ultimately very upbeat and catchy. I've played it countless times this fall, and on my new Spotify account, it actually said that it was my most played song of the year. Even the night was lonely next to me. Where'd you get them scars? So I got into Bleachers around February, and it's kind of a funny story. I went on a random date around that time, and the girl roasted me for only listening to The Killers nonstop, and suggested I listen to the Bleachers, and while nothing happened with her, it was a pointless date. I now own a Bleachers album on vinyl, and have Wild Heart as one of my top songs of 22. because I do like their new music. So when it comes to this song, I love the tenacity of the lyric, "I will find any way to your wild heart." I consider myself pretty tenacious and think that determination is a valuable character trait. I like how the girl's heart is also described as wild instead of something like more traditional such as beautiful. Because wild gives it kind of a turbulent and risky feeling, but also being somewhat natural, as humans are pretty wild animals. This song perfectly captures the feeling of disconnect and confusion one faces after the loss of a relationship or like more situationship. The lyric, "Isn't it strange how we're strangers again?" resonates with me a lot. And if you think about it, we're all strangers in life, but then people come into your life and have a profound impact on it. So they're no longer strangers. Some people are like life-changing, and it seems impossible that they'll ever receive that stranger status again. But with the passage of time, or like with like just general life changes, they can drift away or separate from you. And it's kind of a somber thing to think about, which is reflected in the line, "Ship I pass on summer nights." With that lyric, I envision two ships just passing at sea, or two people passing on the sidewalk, strangers when they shouldn't be. Even only having my Spotify for less than half of the year, I was in the top 1% of Motion City soundtrack listeners, and it was solely because I repeated this song constantly in the fall. "Hold Me Down" emphasizes the positive and negative weights that a romance can bring to your life with the lyric, "I love you, comma, however," and contradicting lines such as, "You're the reason why I burst and why I bloom." My emotions are pretty intense, so when I'm into someone, it elevates me in a really beautiful way, but I also feel really held down and like held back and stressed out. The repeated line, "How will I break the news to you," in the song probably means that the speaker has to break up with the person, but how I see it and like kind of relating to my own experiences, it's more of how will I break the news to the person that I actually like them. In the spring, I went through a phase where I listened to a lot of pop punk for no real reason. And during that time, I listened to a lot of Blink 182 in like April and May. And First Date is definitely their favorite song of mine. I love the driving intensity of the music, which is why I got into some of this music in the first place. And I feel like my mind has this kind of driving intensity with my own thoughts and emotions. Being nervous about a first date is a universal feeling, and that idea is captured well in this song. The chorus of "Let's make this last forever" is really catchy, and it's a meaningful lyric because nothing is forever, but when you're caught up in something, you want it to. You want to do the impossible and overcome the limits of the world and your own humanity to have that exciting feeling last for a long time, even after the first date is over. Let's go, don't wait. This night's almost over. My interpretation of this song is that a heartbroken young woman is looking for that perfect man. Like a knight in shining armor from fairy tales she heard as a young girl. But as the lyrics say, the guy coming doesn't look like Jesus and is thus more of a bad boy stereotype who people probably wouldn't want her for her. But he talks like a gentleman and gets at the root of what she wants anyway, so it's love. I don't know if that interpretation is spot on or not. It's pretty close, probably. But either way, the song is really rocking, and I feel like everyone has conceptions of what love is or what love should be from when they heard stories of love when they were young. And reality can be a little bit heartbreaking because often the people you meet aren't like the people in fairy tales. So everyone wants someone to come in and activate those original desires and have an exciting love. I'm a soon-to-be English teacher, and this year I reread the classic novel Wuthering Heights. I've read it before, but a long time ago, and I pretty much forgot most of it. So when I reread it this year, I became completely obsessed with the book for about a month, and made it almost my entire personality, because it has drama and toxic relationships, and that is kind of fun to read. The book is about ex-lovers Heathcliff and Catherine, and they're really toxic towards one another, but he also grovels for her and is haunted by her ghost and digs up her grave. It's really wild, and Kate Bush, yes, the singer behind Stranger Things, famous song that's on there, Running Up That Hill, has a song based on the book. So Kate Bush's Wuthering Heights is a bit languid, and it reflects kind of the novel because in the book, Catherine's ghost is trying to get into Heathcliff's house, and that's what this song is kind of about. And because I loved Wuthering Heights this year, this song definitely marks some of my 2022 experience, even if I didn't play the song more than the others. This song did come out in 2022, and I really only found it because I was listening to some Charlotte Sands, but the main vocals on this are driving, and the song has a really great back and forth dynamic between the male and female voices. This song is very upbeat and has a driving vibe to it, so I've mainly listened to it when I've work out or exercise. The lyric, "Tell me who you're falling for when we were lying on the floor," is probably my favorite lyric in the song, because people can go through intimate feeling moments together, like lying on the floor while you're drunk or high, and maybe someone will see something more to it, but it not being really there, and then afterwards you might feel like a bit like a fool. But there can also be more overt situations where maybe people actually go on dates together, and it can seem like people, like both parties are interested, but the other person just actually loves someone else and was straight up using you. So that's what this song is about, in my opinion. But instead of taking like this topic and making something depressing about it, this song is kind of upbeat, and it declares that, you know, you never really loved them a little anyway, so you're kind of reclaiming your autonomy and your feelings. I I remember the first time I heard Iris by the Goo Goo Dolls. It was like a transformative experience. I was like, whoa, this is more than music. This is beyond music. It is so poetic. It is sung so well. The instrumentation fits the vibe perfectly. It's not just a love song. It is a song about being human at its core. This song has similar themes to Blue Dahlia, where everyone goes through shit. We have so many massive problems day to day and traumatic experiences in our lives over the years. We can be a collection of scars, but also in the grand scheme of the universe with planets and galaxies, we're actually just incredibly small and worthless. Everything is made to be broken, as Iris puts it, including our hearts. So even if our hearts are made to be broken and the one person does break your heart, maybe they can see you. Maybe they can see you for who you really are and get a glimpse at your soul or something. Iris is about wanting to be seen, recognized, and understood, and that is the most universal and timeless theme of them all. I personally like Big Machine as my favorite Goo Goo Doll song, but this is their most popular song for an undisputed reason. It has over a billion plays on Spotify, and I actually saw them in concert this year, and it was very mesmerizing to sing this song with thousands of other people in the audience. So definitely on my list for 2022.